This is just a quick follow-up to my last video. Someone mentioned in the comments section something I forgot about. That is regarding to the Vatican staircase, which is a spiral as well, of course. You just take a look again, as I showed in the previous video. 666 Park Avenue TV show, which of course is the same exact spiral staircase. Take a look at this image of a serpent. Of course, this is what it's all about. Also, taking a look at Susan Atkins, who I mentioned in my previous video as well. And you see the 666 hand sign over the one eye. Just taking a look at the Pope, the previous Pope from the past. You can see the same exact hand symbol. These Satanists are all about signs and symbols. And interesting enough, you see the Pope here doing the 666 hand sign. This is actually in Phoenix, Arizona, which just so happens to be on the 33rd parallel. This was taken at Sun Devil Stadium, out of all places. Now taking a look at the current Pope of today, Pope Francis. What do you see? The staff, the two snakes swirling around it, just like Baphomet. How obvious can it be that this world is owned and controlled by these Satanists? And for reference, I'll include my previous video here as well. As I've stated many times, Hollywood's all about social programming, shaping and forming the minds of the youth, programming the masses at a very early age. And understand the whole concept behind Hollywood, as I mentioned before, the name Hollywood, or where that derives from, the ancient druids in Europe that used to make witches' wands and magic wands out of Hollywood trees. And that's how you come up with the name Hollywood. Understand the whole concept, the Wizard of Oz and the Yellow Brick Road, and how it's a spiral. This is the exact opposite of the Bible. What the Bible states, they're going to do the exact opposite. Let's play this clip, and then I'll explain what's taking place here. Subconscious programming. Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road. They're going around the road. What does the Bible state? Again, Satanists do things in opposites. They work on duality. States here in the Bible, make your path straight. And of course, this is not a straight path. That's what it's all about. It might seem, you know, very minor detail, but this is the philosophy of the Satanist. We'll get to more about straight path. Make straight the way up to the Lord. It's from John 1:23 and from Jeremiah 31:9. On a straight path, in which they will not stumble. Now again, like I stated, Satanists work on opposites, understanding how the Freemasons that set up our society and how they operate, just like the court system. They make you take an oath in court, just like the Masonic oath that Freemasons take. It states here in the Bible, you're not supposed to take an oath of any kind. Just say yes or no so you're not condemned. Understand again, everything, there is a reason in our society. Take a look again at Wizard of Oz. You know, so many subtle things are taking place in the movie that people, you know, it goes right over their heads. Of course, with Dorothy picking the apple, and of course, this represents the Garden of Eden, just like with Walt Disney movies, with Snow White and the apple symbolism as well. It's right in front of us our entire lives, and people just don't see was taking place, and they can't make the connection. And of course, with the first Apple computer by Steve Jobs, price point was $666.66. Bite into an apple, and of course, the RAM. Of course, getting back to Wizard of Oz and the supposedly the nice witch, the good witch. And what do you see? The satanic pentagram right in plain sight. So there's a good witch and bad witch, but of course, all witches are bad. This is part of the deception. Again, getting back to the spiral symbolism, let's look at Anton LaVey, of course, the founder of the Satanic Church in San Francisco, and Peter Gilmore, the current high priest of the Satanic Church. Just take a look at the symbolisms here. I'll point them out. Let's get a close-up here before I get to the spiral. There's a poster behind them, and it states, I'll get a close-up of that right here, where Satan wants you. And of course, Satanists claim they don't believe in a literal devil. Of course, they cannot admit to the devil being real. If they, in doing so, they also admit God is real. Now let's take a look at this quote from Susan Atkins, of course, a former member of the Church of Satan, where she states, "Anton told me that as a Satanist, he does believe in the God of the Bible, but refused to worship him and made a conscious decision to worship Satan instead." Now getting back on topic with the spiral symbolisms, take a closer look, the spiral above the doorway. Of course, this is not the narrow and straight path. Just like the Dreamcast system, the occult, the orange swirl, of course, orange is 33 in numerology. And a side note on the Dreamcast system itself, just take a look, the entire concept. Flip it over, you see the pyramid with the all-seeing eye, and as when you turn on the system, this illuminates, you get the illuminated eye. Now people can't see what's taking place here. It's beyond me. People think Satan isn't real. Satan doesn't exist. Tell that to the people that own and control this world. Take it. And more of the same with the spiral symbolism. The 666 spiral staircase. People watch this show. Less than probably 1% understand what's taking place here. The symbolism. Let's take a look at this billboard in public for all to see. Make the connection with Sandy Hook and Satanism. Taking a look at the city sign, "Welcome to Sandy Hook," and what do you see? Right in plain sight, like always, the spiral symbolism. Break this down with Sandy Hook, Newtown, nothing but a satanic town. Of course, the Masonic Lodge. Of course, many people have seen this. And as many know, there's a lot of connections with 9/11 and predictive programming with Hollywood movie. The same thing applies to Sandy Hook. Let's take a look at this 2008 movie called Newtown Killers. And you see the as above, so below, like I pointed out in other videos. All revolves around Satanism. With the Masonic goat god, Baphomet. The as above, so below. This movie, Dream House, from 2011. Let's take a look at this business card. I find this very interesting, with the address 1103 Riverside Road in Sandy Hook, Connecticut. Of course, as I mentioned many times, the highest degree in the Scottish Rite of Freemasonry is 33. You get 11 times 3 is 33. Always in plain sight. How obvious can it be? Taking a look at this map here. Just so happens here, Sandy Hook School, where it used to stand, it's no longer there. It's been demolished. And here is Riverside Road. Now, another movie, this one, an animated movie from 2012. It was called Rise of the Guardians. What do you have here? A character named Sandman, also went by the name Sandy. With a character holding a hook. So you got Sandy Hook. There's a connection. Now, the connection, going back in time, I mean, this is pretty reminiscent of 9/11. How far this goes back. Let's take a look at this Judy Garland release of this record album, 1981, called Judy Garland, Annie, Get Your Gun. Look at the close-up here, of course, referring to Sandy Hook, Annie, Get Your Gun, as in taking your guns away. What do you see here in the top left corner? It says Sandy Hook. Amazing coincidence, I'm sure. Take a look, of course, at this geek, Anderson Cooper, holding the Owl of Moloch, supposedly a six-year-old child painted this. Look at the wings, approximately the same size. Highly unlikely, of course, nothing but a hoax, more than likely done by an adult, of course. Let's get a closer look at this owl. You know, always hidden symbolism. Again, take a look at the owl's left eye, and you don't see much. Take a look at the right eye, and you'll see something hidden in plain sight. That you see an N, you see a W, and you see an O for New World Order. Of course, the heart symbolism, all about the occult, like always. And of course, with reference to Judy Garland and Sandy Hook, let's take a listen to this song with the kids singing Somewhere Over the Rainbow, the Sandy Hook Newtown kids. So you see the connection with Sandy Hook, Judy Garland, Annie Get Your Gun. Unbelievable how they love to mock. Getting back to the spiral symbolism, let's take a look here. Hypnotic spiral. You have the third eye, which is a mockery of God who created us with two eyes. Satan tries to outdo God with a third eye, the two lightning bolts, dual symbolism. Like I stated many times, the lightning bolt represents Satan. As Jesus stated, Satan falling from heaven as lightning in Luke chapter 10, verse 18 in the Bible. And taking a look at this movie poster for James Bond 007, it's called Skyfall, it came out in 2012. And of course, the spiral symbolism within the barrel. And taking a look at this 1992 movie titled Dust Devil, of course, the spiral symbolism as well. I'm going to show a clip from downtown Las Vegas. And they call these dust devils as well. Take a look. Of course, it's a spiral within. And to make the connection with CNN and Sandy Hook, let's take a look at who owns, of course, CNN. It's Time Warner. You have the all-seeing eye symbolism of Time Warner. This is Time Warner's logo. It's a combination of the spiral with the Eye of Ra, with the Eye of Lucifer, as it's known as well. And it's integrated to create this logo. And again, the easy connection to make with Sandy Hook. Of course, CNN was all over. They're covering it 24/7. And the spiral. So easy to see what's taking place with those that have eyes to see.